Currently, most ships traveling between the Pacific and Indian Oceans pass through the Malacca Strait, a thin body of water between Indonesia and Malaysia. Every year, 84,000 vessels pass through the strait, carrying 1/4 of the world's traded goods, connecting Persian Gulf oil suppliers to their Asian markets. However, the strait has issues. With an annual capacity of 120,000 vessels, Malacca Strait is already at 70% capacity. At points, the strait is less than 2 miles wide, making it extremely congested and the second largest oil trade choke point in the world. In 2015 alone, there were 60 accidents along the strait. It's also very prone to piracy. Thin, with thousands of inlets and rivers along its shores, the strait is an ideal place for pirates to evade capture. In 2019, the number of Malacca Strait piracy events jumped to 30, up from 8 in 2018. The strait, with piracy and ever-increasing congestion, needs a solution. What if, instead of going through the Malacca Strait, ships could pass through a canal crossing the thin isthmus of Thailand? After all, such a canal would save up to 1,200 kilometers in travel distance. Well, it turns out, this idea has a long history. The idea was first proposed in 1677, but was discarded as impractical with the technology of the time. In 1793, the idea resurfaced and was seriously considered for a century until 1897, when Thailand and Britain agreed not to build a canal to maintain the regional dominance of Singapore. The idea was discussed in the 20th century until 1946, when Thailand once again agreed with Britain not to build the canal. However, after Singapore's independence in 1965, the idea became a real possibility. On May 15, 2015, Thai and Chinese companies signed a memorandum of understanding in Guangzhou to develop such a canal. China, who sees it as part of its Belt and Road Initiative, a global infrastructure development strategy, has offered to provide the majority of technology, funds, and labor to construct the project. It's not surprising. China, which has 80% of its oil supply flowing through the Malacca Straits, is eager to build the canal. Right now, if regional conflict were to erupt, its entire fuel supply could simply be cut off by the US allies that surround the Malacca Strait. Anyways, there are many proposed locations for the Thai Canal. The latest version, as of May 2020, and most favored proposal, would dig through Krabi, Chang, Phatalung, Nakhon Si Thammarat, and Songkhla, Thailand, with a distance of 128 kilometers. For comparison, the Panama Canal is 82 kilometers long, and the Suez Canal is 193 kilometers. This canal would be 450 meters wide and 25 meters deep, making it the widest canal in the world. It would cost around $28 billion, would require 30,000 laborers, and would take around 10 years to construct. It would cut travel distances by up to 1,200 kilometers, equal to several days of sailing time. The canal could hypothetically reduce the cost of crude oil by 9 cents a barrel and reduce annual oil shipping costs by hundreds of millions of dollars. Since the project's introduction, the Thai Canal Association, a group of influential retired military generals and businessmen, have promoted the canal and tried to convince the Thai government to pursue the project. They believe it will boost the Thai economy, help global shipping, and make the country a world logistics hub. And, supported by Beijing, numerous Chinese construction companies have lobbied for the canal. However, it comes with a long list of problems. First, the physical canal will displace thousands of people who will have to be fairly compensated. It will likely harm the environment and will produce massive amounts of excavated soil that will have to be dealt with. It's also feared that the project will separate the south from the rest of Thailand, allowing Muslim insurgents in the south to expand their movement. On top of that, Singapore has raised concerns about the canal's potential impact on its role as a maritime hub and business center. Although many studies conclude there would be little consequence for Singapore, the fear is still there. Finally, it is worried that the canal will extend Chinese influence. With China constructing it and likely controlling it, there's fear that the canal will assist China in dominating the region, giving it the ability to project naval power on the Andaman Sea and Eastern Indian Ocean. Due to all of these problems and fears, the project has not yet taken shape. In February 2018, Thailand's Prime Minister declared that the canal was not a government priority. However, things have heated up again. On January 16, 2020, the Thai House of Representatives, showing unfettered support, agreed to set up a committee within 120 days to study the Thai Canal project. with resumed interest, we may finally see the Thai Canal come to fruition in the near future. What do you think? Is Thailand actually going to build it? And should it? I'd love to talk about it with you in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, join our adventure of the future by clicking that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.